In this video, we're going to go over the standard protocol for extracting DNA from dried split peas. We're also going to see what happens to the DNA yield if we change one step in the protocol. We'll start by going through the standard protocol. The first step is to break down the cell walls of the split peas. This is accomplished by blending 100 grams of dried split peas with 200 milliliters of cold tap water. At this point, we also add 0.6 milliliters of table salt. The sodium ions in the solution will help when we precipitate the DNA later in the protocol. Once everything is added and the lid is secure, blend for exactly 15 seconds. After blending, you'll notice the chopped up split peas on the bottom, a watery greenish layer in the middle, and a foamy layer on top. For our DNA extraction, we only want that watery greenish layer in the middle. So our next step is to carefully strain the extraction mixture, leaving the foam and the chopped up split peas behind. Now we can label our tubes and aliquot 15 milliliters of the strained liquid. While the blending step broke down the hard plant cell walls, we still need to lyse the cellular and nuclear membranes to fully release the DNA. This is done by adding 5 milliliters of dish soap. Now tightly close the tube and gently rock it back and forth 5 times to mix. When finished mixing, return the tube to the rack and leave it for 10 minutes. When the 10-minute waiting period is over and the DNA is fully exposed, it is now at risk of degradation by cellular nucleases. To help prevent this, we add a small amount of protease. In this experiment, our source of protease is a powdered meat tenderizer. Stir the protease into the mixture very gently, since overmixing can break apart the DNA. We're finally ready to precipitate the DNA. Slowly add 20 milliliters of ice-cold 95% ethanol down the side of the tube so that it forms a layer on top of the extraction mixture. You can almost immediately see the DNA start to precipitate at the interface between the extraction mixture and the ethanol. This happens because the salt that we added earlier can now neutralize the DNA and make it hydrophobic. So now, the neutralized DNA essentially wants to get away from the watery extraction mixture, so it clumps together and moves into the ethanol. The DNA needs some time to fully precipitate, so we return it to the rack and let it sit for at least 10 minutes. At this point, we return to a question that we asked earlier in the video. What happens to the DNA yield if we change one step in the protocol? In our case, we're going to change the concentration of ethanol that we use to precipitate the DNA. So our specific experimental question becomes, what is the effect of changing the ethanol concentration on the amount of DNA extracted? To answer this question, we'll run the experiment again, using either 50% ethanol or cold water to precipitate the DNA. All other steps will stay the same. Once we have all of our extractions ready, we can compare the results and answer our experimental questions.